Dear students, today we are going to start our unit number 4, that is carbonyl compounds, which will contain actually aldehydes and ketones. Now what actually we are going to study in this topic, that is what are the meanings of the word aldehyde and ketone, and types of nucleophilic addition type of reactions involved with respect to this carbonyl functional group, that is which is to be present in the compounds, that is aldehydes and ketones. Now carbonyl compounds, these are basically sp2 hybridized with the 3 sp2 hybridized orbitals, and they are going to form an overlap with the orbitals on the oxygen on the top 2 carbon atoms and 1 hydrogen atoms. So this is a carbonyl functional group which is attached with its p orbital. There will be an overlapping between the p orbitals of the oxygen atom and the carbon atom, so there will be a continuous overlap with the electrons which are there in the p orbital of carbon atom and oxygen atom. These 3 bonds adopt triglonar planar symmetry. The remaining unhybridized 2p orbitals on the central carbonyl carbon is perpendicular to the plane of the ring, and they are going to form a side by side p bond. So they are going to form a side by side pi bonds with the 2p orbitals on the oxygen atom. The carbon oxygen double bond, which is polar basically, so this bond which is to be shared the electrons of the carbon atom and the oxygen atom, so this bond is polar in nature, and oxygen is more electronegative than the carbon, so electron density is higher with respect to the oxygen atom as compared to the carbon atom. So the electron density is higher on the oxygen side as compared to the carbon side. So the number of electrons and cloud of electron is towards the oxygen is more as compared to the carbon atom. So this is a representation of the diagram, that the oxygen atom is going to have a more cloud of electron towards itself as compared to the carbon atom. Now the carbon, because it is electron poor, see the oxygen atom is going to attract all the electron towards itself, that's why the carbon atom is electron poor and it is an electrophilic in nature. So it is a great target for the attack by an electron rich nucleophilic group. See the carbonyl carbon atom, in which the oxygen is going to attract all the electron towards itself, that's why the carbon is going to bear a positive charge. That's why the carbon is going to be act as an electrophile, and which is more susceptible to the great target by the attack of an electron rich nucleophilic group. That's why the oxygen end of the carbonyl double bond bears a partial negative charge. As oxygen is going to attract all the electron towards itself, the oxygen is going to bear a negative charge. Anything that cannot help to stabilize this charge by accepting some of the electron density will increase the bond polarity. So anything which will disturb the pi cloud, electron cloud towards this oxygen atom will helps to stabilize the charge which is there on the oxygen atom. So this is will be the representation of the carbonyl functional group, in which the all the electrons will be attracted towards this oxygen atom. That's why this bond is more polar in nature, and as the poor electron density towards this carbon atom, so it is more electrophilic in nature. So any nucleophilic attack will easily happening towards this electrophilic carbon atom. The same effect can also be achieved if the Lewis acid, such as magnesium ion, is located near the carbonyl oxygen. So this type of same effect is to be obtained if the magnesium ions are present nearer about this carbonyl functional group. So when a nucleophile attack on the aldehyde and a ketone carbon atom, so So any nucleophilic attack will happening towards this carbon atom. There is no leaving group. The incoming nucleophile simply pushes all the electrons in the pi bond up to the oxygen. So as oxygen is more electrophilic in nature, so this nucleophile will give his electron to this electron poor carbon atom. As oxygen is already attracted all the electron towards itself, then later on also the electrons which is donated by this nucleophile, they are also pushes towards this oxygen atom. Now after the carbonyl is attacked by a nucleophile, so whenever there will be an attack of the nucleophile towards this carbonyl carbon atom, the negatively charged oxygen has the capacity to act as a nucleophile. That's that time as all the electron attracted towards this oxygen atom, then this oxygen atom can be act as a nucleophile. However, most commonly the oxygen act instead as a base, abstracting a proton from the nearby acid group in the solvent as well as an active enzyme site. So this oxygen atom, as it is going to have a cloud of electron, as it is electron rich species, it will attract a nearby proton from the environment, from the reaction medium, and he is going to form a hydroxyl bond. Meanwhile, as electron carbon is electron deficient, this nucleophilic attack or this nucleophile will form a bond with this carbon atom. So this is very common type of reaction, and this type of reaction is known as nucleophilic addition type of reaction. Now the reactivity of this carbonyl carbon atom towards the nucleophilic addition type of reaction. Now generally aldehydes are more reactive than the ketone. What's the reason behind that? Why aldehydes are more reactive than the ketone? Because of the lack of stabilizing alkyl group. Now the primary carbocation, which is formed in the polarizing resonance structure of an aldehyde, as we have already discussed, oxygen is going to attract all the electron towards itself. That's why this bond is polar in nature. It is less stable, and therefore that's why it is less stable bond, and it is more reactive than the secondary carbocation, which is formed by the ketone. So this polar bond, which is to be formed during this nucleophilic addition reaction, it is more active with respect to the aldehyde than that of the ketone molecule. Now as aldehyde is going to form a primary carbocation, so it is less stable, that's why it is more reactive. When we are talking about the secondary carbocation, which is with respect to the ketone molecule, it is more stable, that's why it is less reactive. So it is less susceptible towards the nucleophilic addition reaction. Now what actually happening when the nucleophilic addition reaction is taken place? There are three fundamental events in the nucleophilic addition reactions, that are formation of new sigma bond between the nucleophile. As we have already discussed, the carbon oxygen bond which is there, the oxygen is going to withdraw all the electrons from the carbon atom. As oxygen is more electronegative, so being the carbon electron poor species, the nucleophile will be attacked on this electron poor carbon species, and there will be a formation of the sigma bond between this nucleophile and the carbon atom. So in this way there will be a formation of a sigma bond between the nucleophile and the carbon atom to the electrophilic carbon of the carbonyl group. Now during this formation there will be a breakage or breaking of pi bond of oxygen. So it is going to break the one of the double bond between the oxygen and the carbon atom, which will results in the formation of an intermediate alkoxide. And this intermediate alkoxide, that is a protonation of the intermediate alkoxide to give an alcohol derivative. So during this nucleophilic attack towards this electron poor carbon species, one of the double bond of the carbonyl functional group is broken down and it will form a new bond with the hydrogen atom. So there will be a formation upon alcohol derivative. Now a strong nucleophile that are anions add directly towards the carbonyl functional group to form an intermediate alkoxide. If the attack of the strong nucleophile will be happening towards this carbonyl carbon atom, so directly there the reaction will be happening without formation of the intermediate product. So there will be a formation of an intermediate alkoxide, and this alkoxide then it is protonated or work up with a dilute acid. Now the nucleophilic addition under basic condition with a strong nucleophile, for example of the reaction, the strong nucleophile which are acting towards this nucleophilic addition of the carbonyl functional group, they are Grignard reaction, lithium alkyl lithiums, then lithium aluminium hydrides and sodium borohydrides. So these are all can be act as a nucleophile towards nucleophilic addition reaction to the carbonyl functional group. Now this is an examples of the strong nucleophiles which are acting towards this carbonyl functional groups. Now we are going to discuss some of the examples of the weaker nucleophiles. Now they are basically neutral in nature and they are going to require the carbonyl functional group which be activated prior to the attack by the nucleophile. So in the case of earlier, the nucleophile will directly attack on the carbonyl functional group, but this is not the case with a weaker nucleophile. We have to activate first the carbonyl functional group and then there will be an attack of the nucleophile. So this can be done using an acid catalyzed which protonate on the Lewis basic oxygen and make the system more electrophilic. So in the earlier case, there will be a directly attack of the nucleophile towards this carbonyl functional group, but this is not the case with a weaker nucleophile. We have to activate this carbonyl functional group first with an attack of Lewis base. So there will be an broken of this carbonyl functional group, that is carbon oxygen double bond, and then the functional group is more susceptible towards the nucleophilic addition reaction. Now this particular attack of weaker nucleophile will requires the presence of acidic condition, because the acid which is present there which will activate the carbonyl functional group towards addition reaction of the nucleophile if the nucleophile is weaker nucleophile. And some of the examples of the weaker nucleophiles are water molecule, alcohols and amine. They are acting as an weaker nucleophile towards addition reactions to the carbonyl carbon atom. Now the reaction of aldehyde and ketone with a hydrogen cyanide. So when we are going to react a nucleophile, that is hydrogen cyanide, with an acetaldehyde, that is aldehyde, so there will be an formation, or there will be a formation of the sigma bond between the nucleophile, that is cyanide, and there will be formation of an alcohol derivative. So this is a product to be formed, that is hydroxypropionitrile. Now what will be the mechanism, how this hydrogen cyanide will react with an acetaldehyde molecule? Now this nucleophile of the cyanide will attack directly on the carbonyl carbon atom. When it is going to act on this electron poor carbonyl carbon atom, now why this carbon atom is electron poor? Because as oxygen is more electronegative in nature, it will attract all the electron towards itself and make this carbon atom electron poor. Now the moment this is acting as an electrophile, the cyanide molecule will act, will form a sigma bond with this carbon atom, and there is formation of an intermediate alkoxide ion, and this is again leaves the cyanide molecule and forms alkyl nitrile derivatives. This is when an acetaldehyde molecule will react with an hydrogen cyanide. Now what happens when the ketone molecule, that is propanone, will react with an nucleophile addition reaction, that is with the hydrogen cyanide molecule? There is formation of an 2-hydroxy-2-methyl propane nitrile. So in this case also there is formation of a nitrile derivative, and the mechanism is similar as like that of acetaldehyde molecule, but the reaction is slows down. It is as the product is more stable, that is a ketone molecule, propanone is more stable, it is going to be react very slowly with the cyanide molecule and going to form a 2-hydroxy-2-methylpropane nitrile derivative. So this is a reactivity of the aldehyde molecule and ketone molecule towards nucleophilic addition reaction. Now before we move forward, we are going to study a very important concept, that is electromeric effect. Now what is the meaning of the word electromeric effect? Electromeric effect, in the case of compound, if it contains multiple bonds, if a compound is going to have a presence of multiple bonds, it may be double bonds, it may be triple covalence bonds, then the electron pair shifts completely towards the more electronegative atom under the influence of attacking reagent. Now just now we have discussed that a oxygen atom will attract all the electron towards itself from the carbon atom also, because there is attack of the nucleophile is happening towards the electron poor electrophile carbon atom. So this concept of attacking all the electron towards electronegative oxygen atom, this concept is known as electromeric effect. So the complete transference of shared pair of electrons of the multiple bond towards one of the atom, and it is to be happening in the presence of attacking reagent, this phenomenon, this concept is known as electromeric effect. A multiple bond or a double or a triple bond consists of sigma and pi bonds. So the electrons of the pi bonds are loosely held due to the multiple bonds, that is double or triple bond, consist of sigma and pi bonds. Of electrons of the pi bonds are loosely held due to the sideways overlapping and easily polarizable. That's why when a compound having pi bond is approached by a charged reagent, a electrophile or nucleophile, the therefore, when a compound having pi bond is approached by a charged reagent, so any compound which is to be a compound having a pi bond, it is to be approached by a charged reagent either as an electrophile or a nucleophile. द इलेक्ट्रॉन ऑफ द बॉन्ड्स आर कंप्लीटली पोलराइजेबल दैट एज अ ऑक्सीजन और द कंपाउंड इज गोइंग टू हैव अट्रैक्ट ऑल द इलेक्ट्रॉन टूवर्ड्स इट्सेल्फ और डिस्प्लेस टूवर्ड्स वन ऑफ द कंसिस्टेंट एटम ड्यू टू द इलेक्ट्रोस्टैटिक अट्रैक्शन और द रिपल्शन. सो इन दिस वे इफ दिस कार्बन एटम विल बी अटैक्ड और इट इज अटैच्ड टू द मोर इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव कार्बन एटम, सो दिस कार्बन एटम विल अट्रैक्ट ऑल इलेक्ट्रॉन टूवर्ड्स इट्सेल्फ. सो इन दिस मैनर इट इज गोइंग टू हैव attracted all the electron towards itself. Now this concept or this phenomenon is known as electromeric effect. So it is basically a temporary effect and comes into play in the presence of an attacking reagent. So this attracting or this shifting or this transference of electron from one carbon atom to the another, any atom, it is happening in the presence of only attacking reagent. And this effect is basically a temporary effect. It takes place in the case of compound having multiple bonds which may be polar or non-polar in nature. Due to the cleavage of the pi bonds and the electron transfer leave their original orbitals and attain a new position. So the electromeric effect is usually denoted as a electromeric effect, basically a positive electromeric effect and negative electromeric effect. The transfer of electron take place, which is represented basically through the curved arrows or curved lines. So if this electron or this group is more electronegative in the presence of attacking reagent, this electronegative group will attract all the electron towards itself. This type of concept or this phenomenon will be happening is known as electromeric effect. Since a carbon is loses its shared electron pair to the X atom, that's why carbon is going to acquire a positive charge, because carbon is also going to give its electron to this compound, that is X. That's why carbon is going to acquire a positive charge and X is going to acquire a negative charge. So the structure which is formed is more stable as the normal structure, and it is formed only at the time of reaction under the requirement of attacking reagent. This type of structure will be formed when it is attacked or when it is reacted with the attacking reagent. If the attacking reagent is withdrawn, if we are going to withdraw the attacking reagent from this reaction mixture without the reaction being allowed to take place, electron distribution revert back to its normal position. So if we are going to remove or if we are going to withdraw this attacking reagent, so this electron, they are again continuously shared between this carbon and oxygen atom, so this reaction will be happening reversibly. This effect is of common occurrence during the addition of the polar reagents towards the carbon-carbon double bond, carbon-oxygen double bond and carbon-nitrogen triple bond. In the case where the inductive effect and electromeric effect simultaneously happening or simultaneously approach, usually the electromeric effect is predominant. Whenever there will be a happening or there will be a presence or the concept of inductive effect and electromeric effect happening simultaneously, that time the electromeric effect predominates as compared to the inductive effect. Now, a direction of shifting of the electron pair from the carbon atom towards the either another carbon atom or oxygen atom or the nitrogen atom. So the direction of the shift of electron pair can be decided on the basis of following points. So the points which are to be discussed towards the direction of shift of electron. When the group linked to a multiple bond are similar, when the group they are linked towards this double bond, triple bonds, if they are similar, the shift can occur to either direction. If the both the sides of this double bonds they are similar, then the shifting of or the transference of electron will be happening in either direction, towards this carbon atom or it may be towards this carbon atom, because
both sides of this double bonds are same. So the shifting of the electron will be happening on either side of the double bond. So this is first. Second one, when the dissimilar groups are linked to the two ends of the double bond, if the two ends of the double bonds are different, then the shift is decided by the direction of the inductive effect. If the double bonded groups are dissimilar, then the shifting of the electrons will be decided by the direction of the inductive effect. Now, in the case of propylene, the shift can be shown in the following steps. So, the double bond, first of all, will shift his electron towards this carbon atom. So, it is going to achieve this intermediate product. And if the electron are shifting happening towards this side, so it is going to give the this type of intermediate product. Now, due to the electron repelling nature of the methylene group, as it is going to repel the electrons, the electronic shift occurs according to the equation 1 way and not by the equation 2. Now, in this case, as methyl group will repel, repelling nature of the methylene group, the electronic shift basically occurs according to this mechanism and not by the second mechanism. Now, the third case, how the shifting of the electron will be happening. In the case of carbonyl group, the shift is always towards oxygen atom because oxygen is more electronegative in nature. If the carbon is doubly bonded to the oxygen atom, that's time the electrons are shifted towards this oxygen atom because the oxygen is more electronegative in nature. In case where the inductive effect and electromeric effect simultaneously happening or simultaneously operate, usually electromeric effect predominates, since the electromeric effect takes place only at a time of attacking reaction. It always facilitates the reaction and never inhibits it. Since the electromeric effect takes place only at the time of attacking reaction, the electromeric effect generally happening at the time of attacking reaction and during the reaction, it always facilitates the reaction and they are going to never inhibit the reaction. Now, what are the types of electromeric effect? We have already discussed. The electromeric effect is basically divided into two types: positive electromeric effect and negative electromeric effect. Now, what is the meaning of the term positive electromeric effect? If an electron pair shifts towards the attacking reaction, it is known as positive electromeric effect. If an electron pair shifts towards the attacking reaction, it is known as positive electromeric effect. So, in this way, if electron pair is shifted towards the attacking reaction, that is why it is known as positive electromeric effect. So, in the case of example 1, in the case of alkane molecule, if attacking reaction, that is H plus ion, so the electron shifted towards the attacking reaction, that is H plus ion, this is also known as positive electromeric effect. And the examples of negative electromeric effect is, at electron pair shift away from the attacking reaction, if the electron pair is shift away from the attacking reaction, it is joining somewhere else in the structure of the compound, it is known as negative electromeric effect. So, in the case of hydroxyne functional group, if the electron pair shift away from the attacking reaction, so it is not acting or there will not be any relation with the attacking reaction, so it is known as negative electromeric effect. Now, some of the differentiating points between inductive effect and electromeric effect. What is the difference between the inductive effect and electromeric effect? inductive effect is basically the permanent effect towards the atoms of the molecule, but the electromeric effect is temporarily. In the presence of attacking reagent only it is happening. If we are going to withdraw the attacking reagent, it will regain its earlier positions or earlier structure. The presence of multiple bond is not essential in the case of inductive effect, but in the case of electromeric effect, the presence of multiple bond is essential. The polarity of the bond is essential in the case of inductive effect. The polarity of bond is not essential in the case of electromeric effect. Partial charges separation take place. Complete charge separation take place. No ions are formed in the case of ions are formed in the case of a reaction with the case of electromeric effect. Attacking reagent is not required in the case of inductive effect, but attacking reagents are required, or the presence of attacking reagent is required in the case of electromeric effect. The displaced electrons do not leave their molecular orbitals. However, distortion of the electron position cloud takes place. But in the case of electromeric effect, the displaced electrons leave their orbital and attain a new position. And the last difference between the inductive effect and electromeric effect is the inductive effect involves mere displacement of the electrons, but the electromeric effect involves complete transference of the pi electrons. So these are some of the differences between the inductive effect and the electromeric effect. Now we are moving towards the discussion on qualitative test used for the determination of the presence of ketones and the aldehydes. Aldehyde and ketone share the carbonyl functional group, which features carbonyl double bond to the oxygen atom. In the case of ketones, there are two carbon atoms, they are bonded to the carbonyl carbon atom, so there will not be any presence of hydrogen atom. But in the case of aldehyde, there is presence of alpha hydrogen atom to a carbon atom of the hydrogen. In all the cases, the carbon that are attached to the carbonyl group may be aliphatic in nature, or not a part of aromatic ring, or aromatic in nature. So the aldehydes and ketone both undergo a reaction type known as nucleophilic addition. Aldehyde and ketone both will undergo nucleophilic addition type of reaction. Under less acidic condition in this type, the reaction that is nucleophile species can donate a pair of electron. In other words, a Lewis base donates its pair of electron to the electron deficient carbonyl carbon, forming a single bond. At the same time, the double bond between the carbon and oxygen atom become a single bond, as one bonding pair of the electrons in the double bond moves to become an unshared pair of the oxygen. So the oxygen now has one bond to it, and it holds three pairs of the unshared electron. So it has a negative charge. Consequently, the oxygen pick up a proton from somewhere, and possibly one that was attached to the nucleophilic atom, that is attached to the carbonyl carbon. So there will be a formation of an hydroxyl functional group. So these are some of the tests used for the identification of presence of a functional group that are aldehydes and ketone. Now the first qualitative test used for the determination of presence of aldehydes and ketones, that are 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazine. So this test is used for the determination of presence of both aldehyde and ketone functional group. Both the functional group will react with a number of nitrogen containing compound through a nucleophilic addition reactions. Subsequent loss of water molecule will take place to give a reaction product that have a carbon nitrogen double bond. So when aldehyde and ketone molecule will react with a 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazine, there will be a formation of a carbon nitrogen double bond to give a color product. These reactions are useful in distinguishing the aldehydes and ketone from other functional groups. So we can determine the presence or the conformation of the aldehyde and ketone functional group, but cannot be used to distinguish between the ketone and aldehyde. So this 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazine can be used to quantitatively detect the carbonyl group functionality of an aldehyde and ketone molecule. So this 2,4-dinitrophenyl will react with either aldehyde molecule to form adduct, which is going to be how this carbonyl oxygen will react with this functional moiety to form the carbon nitrogen double bond. Now the compounds which are to be confirmed by using a standard solutions: cyclohexanone, benzophenone and benzaldehyde. Now the procedure for this test, that is 2,4-dinitrophenol, add a solution of 1 or 2 drops of 30 milligrams of unknown compound in 2 ml of 95% ethanol and 3 ml of 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazine reagent, and check this reaction mixture vigorously. If no precipitate forms immediately, allow the solution to stand for 15 minutes. So if there is a reaction between the aldehyde or ketone functional group with a 2,4-dinitrophenyl, it will form a precipitate, so the test is positive. Now some of the complications for this test is formation of the byproducts. Some ketones give oils which are not solidified. Some alcohol, if not prepared, contain aldehydes or ketone impurities. However, the 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazine is itself orange red, thus the color must be judged with a caution. So we can determine the presence of aldehyde and ketone molecules by 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazine test. Now the second test for the determination of presence of aldehyde and ketone is chromoic test. This test is basically used for the aldehydes. These reactions are usually referred as a nucleophilic addition reactions. Aldehydes are oxidized by the chromic acid and ketones are not. So basically aldehyde will react with the chromic acid and ketones will not react with the chromic acid. When aldehyde is oxidized by the orange brown chromic acid, a chromic acid is reduced to the chromate, which is green. Consequently, chromic acid can distinguish between aldehyde and ketone, because aldehyde molecule will react with the chromic acid molecule. It is also true those other functional groups that are primary, secondary alcohols, they can be oxidized by the chromic acid and cause a formation of the green color. So the procedure for this chromic acid test is basically dissolve 10 milligram of the unknown compound and 1 ml of pure acetone, that is solution, in a test tube and add to the solution of one small drop of the chromic acid reagent, that is Jones reagent, chromic acid in sulfuric acid. A positive test which is marked by the formation of a green color within 5 seconds. And if it is going to be react with the formation of the green color with chromic acid reagent, then the compound contains presence of aldehyde functional group. Then the last and very important test is Tollens test. Aldehydes are usually oxidized by the Tollens reagent. A substance which contains presence of silver ions. So this positively charged silver ions reduced to the metallic silver when it is to be reacted with the aldehyde functional group. So this silver ions, which are precipitated out at as an metallic silver, are very easily oxidized and they are essentially unique in being able to reduce the silver ion to the silver metal ion, and they are deposited on the side of the test tube. So when this aldehyde functional group will react with a Tollens reagent, there is formation of a silver metal which is deposited on the side of the test tube. and meanwhile there is formation of an ammonium salt of the carboxylic acid. Now these are some of the questions that are: why the benzaldehyde is not responded to the Felling test and Tolan test? The reason behind that: benzaldehyde don't have the alpha hydrogen atom to react with the Felling's test and Tolan's test, as there is absence of alpha hydrogen atom. In the case of benzaldehyde molecule, they will not react with the Felling test and the Tolan's test. And the last and very important test is iodoform test for the methyl ketones. Presence of methyl ketones with the help of iodoform test. Methyl ketone but no other ketones are oxidized by the iodine in the sodium hydroxide. The ketone is oxidized to the carboxylic acid and yellow iodoform also forms. So this is a test for the determination of presence of ketone functionally. So today we have discussed about what are basically aldehydes and ketone, what are their general structures and general representation of the aldehydes and ketones, followed by we have discussed two important concepts that are electromeric effect and inductive effect, and last but not the least, that is a qualitative test for the identification of presence of aldehyde and ketone molecules.